something unique.
And I know that Ethan, you were the author of this thing.
The best person to
Good afternoon. It is my pleasure, Prime Minister, my friend, to welcome you in Brussels once again. I would first of all like to thank you for paying a visit soon after your impressive victory in last December's elections and shortly after your new government was sworn in. Your government's focus on values and values-based reforms is deeply appreciated in Europe. I admire your resolve to bring about democratic reforms and economic development, which will benefit all Armenians. The EU will continue to support Armenia's journey towards becoming a consolidated democracy and creating a better economic future for its citizens. We are determined to make the promise of the Comprehensive and Enhanced Partnership Agreement a reality, with real benefits for both Armenia and the EU. The vast bulk of the agreement is already provisionally applied and has a real impact. The EU is Armenia's biggest export partner, with over 28% of Armenian exports. The implementation of this agreement goes hand in hand with domestic reforms. The EU is ready to further support your reform process with enhanced technical and financial assistance. We agree with your strong emphasis on the fight against corruption and the rule of law reform. Today, we also discussed the unresolved Nagorno-Karabakh conflict. As you know, the EU fully supports the Minsk Group co-chairs and their proposals. I am encouraged by the recent contacts between the leaders of Armenia and Azerbaijan and welcome the current decrease in tension. The EU continues to believe that the status quo is unsustainable. The conflict does not have a military solution and needs an early political settlement in accordance with international law. Preparing the respective populations for peace is an important step towards settlement, which we are ready to support. I also thanked the Prime Minister for the valuable contribution Armenia makes to the Eastern Partnership. This partnership celebrates 10 years in May. We have agreed to meet again to take stock of the progress the Eastern Partnership has made over the past decade and to look ahead on the occasion of the anniversary celebrations in May here in Brussels. So I look forward to seeing you back in only 2 months. Finally, let me make one remark about today's editorial by President Macron. Not going into detail, I fully support his way of thinking. Also, when he says, and I quote, "There are external anti-European forces which are seeking openly or secretly to influence the democratic choices of Europeans, as was the case with Brexit and a number of election campaigns." The quote is, "Our first freedom is democratic freedom, the freedom to choose our leaders, as foreign powers seek to influence our votes at every election." And this is the end of quote. "There are external anti-European forces which are seeking, openly or secretly, to influence the democratic choices of Europeans, as was the case with Brexit and a number of election campaigns across Europe. And it may again be the case with the European elections in May. This is why I am calling on all those who care about the EU to cooperate closely during and after the European elections. Do not allow political parties that are funded by external forces hostile to Europe to decide on key priorities for the EU and the new leadership of European institutions. We cannot wait for the renaissance of Europe. The renaissance of Europe must start now. Thank you.
Thank you, dear President Tusk, dear representatives of mass media. This is a second meeting with President Tusk in Brussels and the first one after my reappointment as the Prime Minister of Armenia. I would like to thank you, Mr. President, for the warm welcome and result-oriented discussions. During our today's discussions, we touched upon many different issues ranging from democratic transformations in Armenia to current regional and international developments. We were glad to highlight the existing high level of the political dialogue and cooperation between Armenia and the European Union. I stressed Armenia's determination to enhance the partnership with the European Union. In the course of our discussions, we referred to the early parliamentary elections in Armenia, which were assessed by the international community as being fully in line with the best European practices. There was an unprecedented public trust towards these elections in Armenia. In this context, we also appreciate the assistance of the European Union for the successful organization of electoral processes. Those dynamic political changes that took place in our country, as well as the democratic elections that we had, brought Armenia and the European Union even closer in terms of our shared values. I am proud to declare that democracy is no longer endangered in Armenia. I highly appreciate the European Union's technical and financial support to our government's reform agenda, which among others includes the fight against corruption, promotion of human rights, and consolidation of the rule of law. New Armenia is ready to make steadfast efforts toward enhancing its cooperation with the European Union with new initiatives aimed at supporting our efforts to develop institutions and reinforcing our democratic achievements. I'm glad that our European friends and partners have a similar approach and vision on our bilateral agenda. We are aiming to accomplish ambitious reforms based on the strong mandate of our citizens and compatriots, as well as with the increasing support of our international partners, including the European Union. During our discussion, we touched upon the comprehensive and enhanced partnership agreement, which is an important instrument for enhancing our bilateral relations and implementing our reform agenda. We agreed that the early ratification by all member states is essential and will allow us to fully benefit from the opportunity envisaged by this document. In this context, we discussed the ways of further accelerating the ratification processes. We discussed the visa liberalization process as well. The citizens of Armenia are looking forward to the opportunity of freely traveling to the European Union in the near future. We do hope that the political decision in this matter will be taken shortly, since this will produce tangible results for our citizens and give our partnership even more visibility. During our meeting with President Tusk, we also touched upon the upcoming 10th anniversary of Eastern Partnership. I reiterated our willingness to actively engage in the joint preparations for the 10th anniversary of Eastern Partnership. We also discussed the regional issues. We appreciate the EU's continuous balanced position on the Nagorno-Karabakh conflict, which supports the OSCE Minsk Group co-chairs, their position and efforts for the peaceful resolution. This is a valuable contribution to the peace and security in our region. I reiterated that Armenia is fully committed to the exclusively peaceful resolution of the Nagorno-Karabakh conflict. In conclusion, I want to express confidence that our existing dialogue and the fruitful discussions that we had today will contribute to the further enhancement of our partnership and the implementation of an already ambitious agenda of bilateral relations in all the fields of common interests. I would like to once again thank you, Mr. President, for your warm welcome. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Okay,